Can you say praise the Lord?
¿Puedes alabar al Señor?
I will challenge you to give the Lord a great big hand clap.
Te reto a que ponga tu mano, de un aplauso al Señor.
Amen. You know, it's one of the things that we are always challenged.
Es una de las cosas, es un reto.
That no matter what we are going through in life,
no importa lo que esté atravesando en la vida,
we must always remember.
Siempre acuérdate.
That.
¿Qué?
No matter what's going on.
No importa lo que esté pasando.
If we are children of the Most High,
si somos hijos del Altísimo,
He is in charge.
Él está en control.
And He will never leave us alone.
Y nunca te abandonará.
Even in the darkest moments,
en los momentos más oscuros,
He is with us.
Está con nosotros.
Can you say amen?
¿Puedes decir amén?
I'm going to ask you, if you have a Bible, please go to the Gospel of Mark.
Si tienen la Biblia, vaya al Evangelio según San Marcos.
Chapter 7.
Capítulo 7.
And let us look at verse 6.
Versículo 6.
And 7.
Y 7.
And although it may look odd,
parece medio raro,
of what I'm going to cover with this,
lo que voy a cubrir con esto acá,
I believe you will understand it as we go along.
Vas a entenderlo mientras continuamos hacia adelante.
I want to speak to you.
Quiero hablarle a usted.
Real briefly on.
Brevemente.
Five spiritual principles.
Cinco espíritus principales.
That changes the spiritual and natural atmosphere.
Que cambia la atmósfera espiritual y material.
Let me repeat that again.
Dame a repetirlo de nuevo.
Five spiritual principles.
Cinco espíritus principales.
That changes.
Que cambia.
The spiritual.
Lo espiritual.
And the natural atmosphere.
Y la atmósfera natural.
We read in the Gospel of Mark chapter 7.
Leemos en el libro de Marcos capítulo 7.
Beginning in verse 6.
Comenzando en el versículo número 6.
He replied.
Y Jesús contestó.
Isaiah was right when he prophesied about you hypocrites, as it is written.
Bien hablado el profeta Isaías acerca de los hipócritas que son ustedes cuando describió.
This people honor me with their lips.
Este pueblo me honra con su boca.
But their hearts are far from me.
Pero su corazón está muy lejos de mí.
They worship me in vain.
De nada sirve que me rindan culto.
Their teachings are but rules.
Sus enseñanzas son mandatos.
Taught by men.
De hombre.
In verse 8.
Y versículo número 8.
You have let go of the commands of God.
Porque ustedes dejan el mandato de Dios.
And are holding
para seguir
to the traditions of men.
Tradiciones de los hombres.
Thank you, Father, for your word.
Gracias, Padre, por tu palabra.
I ask that at this moment,
pido en este momento,
you will continue to anoint my lips,
que unja mis labios,
that you will open my mind,
abre mi mente,
and that you will help us all,
que nos ayude a todos,
to hear what your word has to say.
Para escuchar lo que tu palabra va a decir.
May I make this point
cuando hago estos puntos
clear.
Claro.
And may you through your Holy Spirit
y a través de tu Espíritu Santo usted
awaken us.
Despiértanos.
Touch us.
Tócanos.
Revive us.
Vívenos.
Save us.
Sálvanos.
Heal us.
Sánanos.
And deliver us.
Y haznos libres.
For the glory of your precious name.
Por la gloria de tu precioso nombre.
In the name of your Son.
En el nombre de tu Hijo.
The Messiah.
El Mesías.
Jesus.
Jesús.
In whose name, Father.
En el nombre.
We trust you.
Confiamos en ti.
Amen.
Amen.
We see here that
vemos acá
the Messiah was rebuking
el Mesías estaba reprendiendo
the leaders of Israel.
Los líderes de Israel.
A lot of people use this and just apply it to everybody.
A mucha gente usan esto y se lo aplican a todo.
But that wasn't really the case.
Pero eso no era el caso.
He was rebuking the leaders
estaba reprendiendo los líderes
because they had put more importance
que le habían puesto más importancia
to their traditions
a sus tradiciones
than to the word of God.
Que a la palabra de Dios.
The reason why I want to touch briefly on these five spiritual principles is because they are spiritual laws that are at work that can open things up or close them off in both the supernatural and on the natural territory. We are human beings. We are so used just to pay attention to the natural atmosphere. And we tend to forget that our Creator, our Father,
Padre,
He who has given us the breath of life,
que nos dio el soplo de vida,
dwells in the supernatural.
Vive en lo supernatural.
To the degree
al tal grado
that we need to understand
tenemos que entender
that the kingdom of God,
que el reino de Dios,
is very powerful.
Es poderoso.
And there are spiritual laws
y hay leyes espirituales
that are associated with His kingdom.
Que son asociadas con su reino.
And that you and I,
que usted y yo,
even as we are,
como somos.
So I don't know about you,
no sé de usted,
but oftentimes
no, de vez en cuando,
when I look at myself
me miro,
and I look at all of my faults
y veo todas mis faltas,
and all of my frailties
y todas mis fallas,
I have to question,
tengo que preguntar,
how in the world,
como en el mundo,
can such a powerful holy being,
que un ser tan poderoso y santo,
care about me?
Le importe yo.
Hello.
Hola.
Because I don't know about you,
no sé de usted,
but many times,
pero muchas veces,
people will look at you,
gente te mira,
and this time I'm going to put me there.
Y me voy a poner ahí.
People may look at me,
gente me mira,
and see nothing but my faults.
Ve toda mi falla.
See nothing but that which they do not like about me.
Ve las cosas que no le agradan de mí.
But blessed be the name of Jesus.
Bendecido el nombre de Jesús.
Because when He looks at me,
cuando me mira,
He doesn't see me as I was.
No me miro como era.
He doesn't see me as I am.
No me ve como soy.
But He sees me as I can be in Him.
Ve, me ve como puedo ser en él.
Can you praise His holy name?
Adora su nombre.
He has given you and I
le ha entregado a usted y a
the
mí
power,
el poder,
the authority,
autoridad,
and the dominion
y el dominio
to activate
para activar
these laws in the natural,
las leyes lo natural
that comes from the supernatural.
Que viene de lo supernatural.
Therefore,
por eso,
principle number one,
principal número uno,
in order to activate the supernatural in the natural,
lo supernatural en lo natural
is faith.
Fe.
Wow, that sounds so simple.
Wow, simple suena eso.
Doesn't it?
No suena simple.
To how many of us does that sound so simple?
¿Para cuántos de acá en la casa sonó tan simple?
Don't be afraid to put your hands up.
No tenga miedo de levantar tus manos.
I like you to talk to me.
Háblame.
I told you I'm a lot different.
Te dije que yo soy muy diferente.
Faith.
Fe.
Being sure.
Estar seguro.
And trusting God.
En confiando en Dios.
Even when things look the opposite.
Cuando todo se ve opuesto.
Hello.
Hola.
Isaiah 41 and 10 says.
Isaías 41, Dios dice.
Fear not.
No tengas miedo.
For I am with you.
Porque estoy contigo.
Be not dismayed.
No te desmayes.
For I am your God.
Porque soy tu Dios.
And I like this.
Me encanta esto.
Listen to what he says.
Escucha lo que dice.
I will strengthen you.
Te fortaleceré.
Yes, I will help you.
Sí, te ayudaré.
I will uphold you.
Te sustentaré.
With my righteous right hand.
Con la diestra de mi mano.
I don't know if you understand what that means.
No sé si tú entiendes lo que significa.
But when he speaks of his righteous right hand,
cuando habla de su mano derecha y justicia,
he is speaking of authority.
Habla de autoridad.
He is speaking of Ana.
Habla de Ana.
He is speaking of ¿qué, Ana?
Didn't you say Ana?
No.
Oh, my bad.
Se lo voy a decir, ¿sabe a quién? No, aquí no está. He is speaking of authority.
Habla de autoridad.
As a matter of fact, when it's talking about Jesus,
cuando habla de Jesús,
and his ascension,
y su ascendencia,
where does the Bible says that Jesus is seated at?
¿Dónde dice la Biblia que Jesús está sentado?
That's right. Talk to me, people.
Háblame, pueblo.
He is seated at the right hand of the Father.
Está sentado a la diestra de Dios Padre.
But you know, there's something beautiful.
Algo hermoso.
The Bible says
la Biblia dice
that although you and I are here in the natural,
aunque usted y yo estamos acá en lo natural,
in the spiritual,
en lo espiritual,
where does the Bible say that you and I are seated?
¿Dónde la Biblia dice que usted y yo estamos sentados?
Together with the Son.
Junto con el Hijo.
So if the Son is at the right hand of the Father,
si el Hijo está a la mano derecha del Padre,
and supernaturally speaking,
y hablando supernatural,
you and I are seated together with the Son,
estamos sentados tú y yo junto con el Hijo,
then it means
significa
that you and I have been given the honor,
nos dieron el honor
and have been given the privilege,
y el privilegio,
to speak on His name,
hablar de su nombre,
and to believe
creer
that the blessings,
que la bendición,
no matter how dark it may look in our lives,
no importa cuán oscuro vea tu vida,
no matter what we're going through in our lives,
atravesando nuestra vida,
we are blessed in Messiah.
Somos bendecidos a través del Mesías.
The second principle,
el segundo principal,
is belief.
Creer.
It was the unbelief of the people
fue la duda de la gente
that prevented Jesus,
que previno que Jesús,
from doing miracles at times,
de hacer milagros en vez en cuando.
Listen.
Escucha.
It's not because Jesus didn't have the power to do the miracles.
No era porque Jesús no tenía el poder para hacer los milagros.
It's not because Jesus doesn't have the power to deliver you and me.
No, no es que no tenga el poder para saltarnos a ti a mí libre.
No. It's because He wants you and me to believe that He can do it.
Él quiere que usted y yo creamos que Él lo puede hacer.
In Matthew 13,
Mateo capítulo 3,
verse 55 on.
55.
It said that the people questioned this, right?
La gente hicieron pregunta de esto.
They said, isn't this the carpenter's son?
Este no es el hijo del carpintero.
Isn't his mother's name Mary?
No, la madre de él es María.
Aren't his brother's name James?
Y su hermano se llama
Joseph,
Santiago, José,
Simon and Judas.
Simón y Judas.
And his sisters, don't they live with us?
Y sus hermanos no viven con nosotros.
Where then did this man get all these things from?
¿Dónde este hombre consiguió todo esto?
And they took offense at him.
Y le, se ofendieron de él.
But Jesus said to them,
y Jesús les dijo a ellos,
a prophet is not without honor.
No hay un profeta con honor
in his own town,
en su propia tierra,
in his own home,
en su casa.
And he did not do many miracles there,
no hizo muchos milagros,
because of their lack of faith.
Por la falta de fe.
Ooh. When God works miracles in our lives,
cuando Dios trabaja milagros en nuestras vidas,
one of the things that He will do,
una de las cosas que él hace,
is always look for an occasion.
Busca una ocasión.
He will set you up, so to speak,
te setea,
for you to give testimony,
para que tú testifiques,
of what the Lord has done for you.
Lo que él hizo por usted.
I lived this week
viví esta semana
a number of times,
numerous veces,
even at my job.
En el trabajo también.
I was even relating to someone,
me estaba relacionando con alguien,
how God delivered me from death,
cuando Dios me salvó de la muerte,
from a brain aneurysm,
de un tumor en la mente,
where the surgeon said that I should have been dead,
cuando el cirujano dijo que tuviera tal, debo de estar
because
muerto.
What I described to him,
lo que le describí a él,
was when a brain aneurysm burst in your head,
cuando algo está en tu mente,
and it happened to me twice in one day.
Y dos veces en un día.
Are you listening to me?
¿Estás poniendo atención?
Yet that thing was so big in my head.
Esa cosa era tan grande en su cabeza.
And when I described it to him,
cuando se lo describió a él,
he came back running,
vino corriendo,
wondering,
preguntando,
and telling me,
y diciéndole,
I don't know if you believe in God,
no sé si tú crees en Dios,
but it is a miracle that you are alive.
Es un milagro que tú estás vivo.
Because what you describe,
lo que me describiste,
normally people are dead within 2 hours afterwards.
Normalmente las personas están muertas después de 2 horas.
But you see something.
¿Ves algo?
I don't serve,
yo no sirvo,
any God.
Cualquier Dios.
No, I serve the true living God.
Yo sirvo al verdadero Dios viviente.
I serve the God who spoke everything into existence. I serve the God that one day spoke me into existence. I serve the God that one day breathed into my nostrils and gave me life. And as long as he wants to keep me on this earth, he will do so. And if you want to know anything about Miguel Ángel Cotto, the one thing I will always tell you, don't look at me, but look at the one who dwells in me. Let me move on. Let me move on.
Dame continuar.
Principle number three.
Principal número tres.
Give.
Da dones. Give.
Giving.
Dando.
If you can say amen, say ouch.
Si no puedes decir amén, dime, duele.
Because that's the hardest part in our lives.
Ese es el peso más duro en nuestra vida.
You must activate giving.
Tiene que activar el
in
dar
order to receive.
Para recibir tienes que dar.
And we're not talking just about money.
No hablamos solamente de dinero.
Because I'm pretty sure that when I say giving,
cuando yo digo de dar,
you probably went like this. Like,
apretate el bolsillo.
Luke 6:38.
Lucas 6:38.
Give and it will be given to you.
Dar y se te será dado.
A good measure.
Una medida buena.
Press down.
Haga ahora.
Shaken together. Go ahead.
Menecen juntos.
Running over.
Corriendo.
Will be poured into your lap.
En tu falda.
For with the measure that you give.
Con la medida que das.
And you measure.
En tu medida.
You will receive and it will be measured to you.
Va a ser recibida para atrás.
Do you give mercy?
¿Das tu misericordia?
Are you merciful to people that do not deserve mercy sometimes?
¿Eres misericordioso con gente que no merecen la misericordia?
Hello.
Hola.
Because I tell you that in my teenage years,
te digo en mi juventud,
growing in the streets of Harlem,
creciendo en la cajetera de Harlem,
when I was a gang banger,
cuando era ganguista,
a drug user,
usador de droga, adicto.
I know a lot of people look at me and say, no.
Oh,
yes.
Sí.
I love getting high.
Me encantaba embollarme.
Like there was no tomorrow.
Como que mañana no viene.
I used to love smoking my joint.
A fumar mi gallo
early in the morning,
temprano en la mañana,
during the day,
en el día,
and late at night,
y en la noche.
I know some of you are so holy you can't even think about
ay,
that.
Muchos de ustedes son santos.
While I was destroying my body,
mientras estaba destruyendo
with
mi cuerpo,
the drugs that I was using,
con la droga que consumía,
when I even had died at the age of 16 from an overdose,
cuando morí en la edad de 16 de sobredosis,
that creator,
ese creador,
he had a purpose for my life.
Tenía un propósito para mi vida.
And when I did not deserve any mercy,
cuando no merecía misericordia,
when I did not deserve any favor,
cuando necesitaba favor,
when I did not deserve any grace,
cuando no merecía gracia,
he looked at me,
me miró,
and he brought me back to life.
Me trajo otra vez a vida.
In the way to the hospital,
en el camino al hospital,
from Harlem,
de Harlem,
to the Metropolitan Hospital at that time.
Metropolitano de aquel entonces.
It was from 123rd Street
de la 123
to 96th Street
hasta la 96
in New York.
Nueva York.
So you can imagine the traffic.
Imagínate el tráfico.
And here they're trying to rush me to the hospital.
Y tratando de llegarme al hospital.
I died three times in the way there.
Morí tres veces rumbo al hospital.
And three times.
Y tres veces.
I like to joke about it.
Me gusta relajar.
I think God sent an angel.
Dios mandó un ángel.
And he just smacked me right awake.
Y me metió una pescosa para despertarme.
You'll get it later. You'll get it later. You know why I tell you that?
¿Sabes por qué le digo esto?
Because that's the way I felt every time they hit me with that thing.
Eso fue la manera que sentí cuando me despertaron con la electricidad.
Like somebody just had smacked the daylights out of me.
Como que le entraron a pescosa.
Except that it was the opposite.
Pero era opuesto.
They smacked the daylights into me.
Metieron los cantazos adentro de él.
Hello, somebody.
Hola, pueblo.
You may be living a life.
Está viviendo un estilo de vida.
Oftentimes,
de vez en cuando,
where people may point the finger at you,
o donde te señalan,
when people may think that you do not deserve another day on earth.
Cuando gente, personas dicen, tú no mereces un día más de
vida
en la
tierra. But let me tell you something.
Déjame decirte algo.
You who are under the sound of my words right now.
Los que están en la escucha de mi voz.
God,
Dios,
God,
Dios,
does not make any mistakes.
No comete ningún error.
Even the fact.
La
aún el hecho.
Aún the fact.
Okay, so now he's gonna. Okay. That you and I are here today.
Que tú y yo estamos acá hoy.
Is not by coincidence.
Es por coincidencia.
It's not necessarily because you and I made that choice.
Es porque, ni porque tú y yo hicimos esa.
But God has
decisión.
A purpose.
Pero Dios tiene un propósito.
God is trying to give to you.
Dios está tratando de darte a ti.
His life.
Su vida,
his power,
su poder,
his anointing,
su unción,
his deliverance,
su
and we praise his living name.
Y adoramos su nombre viviente.
Can you say amen?
Diga amen.
Principle number four.
Principal número cuatro.
Forgive.
Perdonar.
Yeah, I knew there were some ouches I had to come because I felt them too. Forgiving.
Perdonar.
Forgiving.
Perdonar.
It was written in a medical journal.
Fue escrito un jornal medical.
About 15 years ago, I read it.
Como 15 años atrás.
Of people that were suffering
de gente que estaban sufriendo
from major arthritis.
De una artritis grande. Crónica, artritis crónica.
How the bones were hurting.
Como le dolían los huesos.
How the muscles were twisting.
Como se le viraban los músculos.
And do you know that they made this study?
¿Y tú sabes que hicieron este estudio?
And they found out
y encontraron
that a large number of them
la mayoría de ellos
were suffering from this.
Sufrían de esto.
Due to a lot of resentment that they held in.
De resentimiento que aguantaron adentro.
Unforgiveness.
Sin perdonar.
Hello, somebody.
Hola, pueblo.
And during the therapy.
Y durante la terapia.
They asked these people.
Le preguntaron a la gente.
Who do you need to forgive?
¿A quién tiene que perdonar?
And they said that oftentimes.
Dijeron de vez en cuando.
When they began to forgive those that offended them.
Cuando pegaron a perdonar los que lo ofendieron.
Their bodies began to react differently.
Sus cuerpos comenzaron a reaccionar diferente.
Their arthritis began to release from their bodies.
La artritis comenzó a salir de su cuerpo.
Listen, the word resentment.
Resentimiento,
comes
la palabra,
from a Latin word
viene de una palabra latina,
that means to feel again.
Para sentir, significa sentirlo otra vez.
To live it again.
Vivirlo otra vez.
Resentment means.
Resentimiento significa.
They say if Luis offended me.
Si yo ofendo a Miguel.
And I keep thinking about his offense.
Pienso siempre en su ofensa.
And every time that I think about his offense.
Pienso siempre en su ofensa.
I feel hurt within.
Me duele adentro.
And besides the pain.
Y después del dolor.
I feel anger.
Siento coraje.
I am resenting him.
Tengo resentimiento
hacia and I am reliving that experience.
Estoy viviendo la experiencia de nuevo.
Resentment is a major killer.
Es un matador mayor.
Among human beings.
Entre nosotros los humanos.
You know how many people oftentimes
¿sabes cuánta gente de vez en cuando
die with a heart filled with resentment?
Con un corazón de resentimiento.
However, the Bible tells us
la Biblia nos dice
that we must forgive
tenemos que perdonar
in order to be forgiven.
Para recibir perdón.
Listen,
escucha,
resentment can be so bad
es tan malo
that even the servants of the Lord
y que en los sermones del Señor
at one time
en un punto dado,
wanted to do something.
Quería hacer algo.
In Luke chapter 9,
Lucas capítulo 9
verse 51,
versículo 51,
it tells us
nos dice,
that at one time they approached
una vez se la acercaron,
and when they went and set out for Jerusalem
cuando iban de camino a Jerusalén,
he sent messengers ahead of him.
Mandaron mensajeros delante
they
de
went
ellos.
Into a Samaritan village to get things ready for him.
Entraron a una aldea samaritana.
But the people there did not welcome him.
La gente ahí no le recibieron.
Because he was heading for Jerusalem.
Porque iba para Jerusalén.
Now listen to this, what the disciple James and John did.
Mira lo que los discípulos Santiago y Juan hicieron.
When they saw this,
cuando ya se acercaba,
they asked the Lord,
el tiempo en que Jesús,
Lord,
Señor,
do you want us to call fire down from heaven to destroy them all?
¿Queremos que haga descender fuego del cielo para destruirlo a todos?
Ouch.
Ay.
How many times have somebody hurt you? How many times have somebody offended you? How many times have you forgiven a person that continues to hurt you?
¿Cuántas veces tú has perdonado? ¿Cuántas veces tú has perdonado a una persona que te sigue ofendiendo?
And how many times,
¿cuántas veces?
Just like the disciples,
como los discípulos,
you wish you could call fire from him and
tú desearías que descendiera fuego del cielo y destruirlos a todos.
But it says,
pero se dice,
that the Messiah turned to them,
el Mesías se viró,
and he rebuked them,
y los reprendió.
And he then went to another village with them.
Y después se fue a otra aldea con ellos.
No matter how hard it may be,
no importa cuán duro sea,
remember,
recuérdate,
he has forgiven you and me,
te perdonó a ti y a mí,
for all the wrong that we have done,
por todos los males que hemos cometido.
And even as his children,
y como hijos,
when we fail,
cuando fallamos,
all we have to do,
lo que tenemos que hacer,
is humble ourselves,
humillarnos,
under the mighty hand of God.
Debajo la mano poderosa de Dios.
And when we humble ourselves,
cuando nos humillamos,
and we repent,
y nos arrepentimos,
he says that he will forgive us.
Él dice que él nos perdona.
The last one, number five.
El punto número cinco y el último.
I told you I was going to go get you out to the Puerto Rican parade.
Yo le dije a ustedes que iban para la parada puertorriqueña.
Another way,
otra manera,
to bring the supernatural,
para traer lo supernatural,
into the natural,
a lo natural,
is to bless,
es bendecir,
and not to curse,
y no maldecir.
Ouch.
Ay.
Remember that if you judge,
recuérdate que si juzga,
we said it before, you will be judged by the same measure.
Vas a ser juzgado con la misma medida.
Why are these things so important?
¿Por qué esto es importante?
Again, because they are spiritual laws and principles,
porque hay leyes espirituales y principales,
at work,
trabajando,
that can open things up,
que pueden abrir cosas,
or close them off,
o cerrarla.
You and I,
tú y yo,
if we are children of the Most High,
si somos hijos del Altísimo,
if we have turned our lives over to the Lord,
si le hemos entregado nuestra vida al Señor,
if we have bowed down before him,
si nos hemos postrado delante de
and
él,
told him,
dile a él,
Jesus,
Jesús,
I want you to be the Lord and Savior of my life.
Quiero que sea el Señor y Salvador de mi vida.
I may not understand this.
No entiendo esto.
I may not be aware of your word.
No sé. Tengo conocimiento de tus palabras.
I may not be sure how I should walk this path.
No estoy seguro cómo tú caminas en este camino.
It doesn't matter.
No importa.
All that he wants is you and I.
Lo que quiere es él y usted.
To give ourselves to him.
Entregarnos a él.
Remember that one day,
recuérdate que un día,
he died at Calvary's cross.
Murió en el Calvario.
There he shed his blood for you and me.
Él derramó allí su sangre por usted y por mí.
Even listen to what he said to his
disciples.
At one time he said, don't you know that I could call legions of angels and they would deliver me from all this? However, it was him who said in John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave. He gave. He gave. Do you know the greatest gift that God has given you and me? It is the gift of his son. He gave his only begotten son, that whosoever should believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. You know, most people concentrate only on this life.
vida.
Waking up.
Despierta.
Going to sleep.
Se despiertan, se van a dormir.
Waking up.
Se despiertan.
And going to sleep.
Y se van a dormir.
Lord have mercy.
Dios tenga misericordia.
I don't know about you, but some of us have been waking up and going to sleep for a mighty long time.
Muchos de nosotros hemos ido a acostarnos y a dormir por largo tiempo.
And I don't know about you.
No sé de usted.
Sometimes when you look around,
cuando miras a tu alrededor,
I look at my children.
Miro a mis hijos.
I look at my grandchildren.
Mis nietos.
And they are getting bigger.
Están creciendo.
And bigger.
Creciendo.
And bigger.
Grande.
And you know what?
¿Sabes qué?
They remind me.
Me recuerdan.
How short life really is.
Cuán corta es la vida.
Hello.
Hola.
One day you had that nice thick hair.
Una vez tenía esa melena.
And now you buy all kind of stuff just to try to make something grow.
Y ahora está pasándole algo para que crezca.
One day your hair was nice and pitch and black.
Una vez tu pelo era negro.
Or brown,
o brown,
or red,
rojo,
blonde,
rubio.
And now you kind of like going like this, looking in the mirror and going.
Ahora está con la twist, arrancándote con la pinza.
Trying to pull them white hairs out.
Tratando de sacarte las canas.
But guess what?
¿Sabes qué?
That's nature.
Esa es la naturaleza.
That's life.
Eso es vida.
That's the natural.
Eso es lo natural.
But thank God Almighty,
gracias al Dios,
that He has promised us something supernatural.
Él nos prometió algo supernatural.
Those of us who have believed in Him.
Los que han creído en Él.
Listen, those of us who have believed in Him.
Los que han creído en Él.
In Luke 17:21, He tells us,
Lucas 17:21 dice,
for in thee the kingdom of God is within you.
Porque en ti el reino de los dioses está en ti.
Let me end with this.
Déjame terminar con esto.
There is power.
Hay poder.
Where we put our thoughts.
Donde ponga tus pensamientos.
There is power.
Hay poder.
Where we put our prayers.
Donde ponemos nuestras oraciones.
There is power.
Hay poder.
Where we put our actions.
Donde ponemos nuestras acciones.
There is power.
Hay poder.
When people say yes to God.
Cuando la gente dice sí a Dios.
There is power.
Hay poder.
Also when people say no to sin.
Cuando le dicen no al pecado.
Hello somebody.
Hola, pueblo.
There is power when you and I choose to do the right thing, even when it's easier to do the wrong thing. That is one of the things that I teach my guys in prison. As a drug and alcohol counselor in the Philadelphia prison system, in February will be 27 years that I've been working there, and you'll be surprised how many of those inmates have gone out and come back in, out and come back in, bound by an addiction. But let me tell you something. We preach, we believe, we serve a living God, a God that can deliver from addiction. He delivered me from addiction, and I believe He can deliver anyone from addiction. He delivered me from a criminal lifestyle, and I believe He can deliver anyone from a criminal lifestyle. I believe in a God who one day called my name. I believe in a God that the Bible says He knows every hair upon my head. I believe in a God that still is calling people to salvation. I believe in a God that has given you and me the power to bring the supernatural into the natural. Can you bless His holy name? That is the God that we preach. That is the God that we believe. And it doesn't matter what it looks like. See, the people of faith. This is the way we are called to live our life. No matter how much darkness surrounds
us,
we always see the light.
Siempre vas a ver la luz.
Give them a great hand clap. Father, we thank you.
Padre, te damos gracias.
And we praise your living name.
Y adoramos tu nombre viviente.
Father,
Padre,
thank you for your word.
Gracias por tu palabra.
Thank you because you always encourage us.
Gracias por animarnos.
Thank you, Father.
Gracias, Padre.
Because we trust in your revival.
Confiamos en tu avivamiento.
We trust in that you will reach
vas a alcanzar, confiamos,
our loved ones,
nuestros seres queridos,
our families,
nuestra familia,
our children,
nuestros hijos,
our neighborhoods,
nuestros barrios.
Father, we trust in
confiamos
that there's going to be a great awakening.
Van a un gran despertar.
Here in Philadelphia,
en la ciudad de Filadelfia,
here in Pennsylvania,
en Pennsylvania,
and here in the United States of America,
los Estados Unidos de América,
and throughout the face of the earth.
Y a través del planeta Tierra.
And we stand, Father,
y nos paramos
on your word,
tu palabra,
and we call upon your name.
Y llamamos tu nombre.
And right now,
y ahora,
I pray, Father,
oramos,
if there's anyone here
si hay alguien aquí,
that need
que necesita
to know you
conocerte a ti,
in a more intimate fashion,
de una manera íntima,
let them right now give their lives over to you. Father, we extend this invitation and we ask, is there anyone that needs to know you in a more intimate way? Anyone that would love to confess Jesus as their Lord and as their Savior? At this moment, Father, we ask, we pray, we bless. Hallelujah, Father.
Hallelujah, Padre.
Right now,
ahora,
in the name of Jesus,
en el nombre de Jesús,
we extend this invitation.
Extendemos la invitación.
As the people of God help me to pray,
mientras que la gente del pueblo me ayuda a orar,
as you meditate in the Lord,
mientras medita en el Señor,
we extend this invitation.
Extendemos esta invitación.
Is there anyone in need of prayer?
If any, alguien necesita oración,
for salvation,
salvación,
for deliverance,
libertad,
for healing,
sanidad,
whatever the matter may be,
cual sea el problema,
here you God,
aquí,
men and women of God,
hombres y mujeres de Dios,
that are willing to pray with you,
que quieren orar por ti.
As the music plays,
mientras la música toca,
if you are in the need of prayer,
si necesitas la oración,
and you want someone to pray for you,
quieres que alguien ore por usted,
please come forward.
El altar está abierto.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Y si no tienes a Cristo,
and if you have Christ,
hoy yo te lo presento.
I present him to you today.
Jesús es el Salvador del mundo.
Jesus is the Savior.
Murió por ti y murió por mí.
Died for you and for me.
Él es mi Salvador.
He is my Savior.
¿Lo quieres como Salvador?
You want him as a Savior?
Acéptalo.
Accept him.
Y dile, Señor, reconozco que soy pecador.
Lord, I recognize that I'm a sinner.
Perdona mis pecados.
Forgive my sin.
Te recibo.
I receive you.
En esta hora.
In this hour.
Como mi Salvador.
As my Savior.
Gracias a los hermanos. Dios me los bendiga. Un abrazo y un beso para cada uno de ustedes. Que la paz de Dios sea sobre ustedes y sobre su nación.
El Faro Media Ministry.